This is my working Lego bowling alley, which I showcased in my last video. In today's video, we're gonna put it to the ultimate test. Can my Lego bowling alley help me with real life bowling?
So to answer this question, I had to take a trip to the bowling alley.
At the bowling alley, things didn't start out well, with me looking like I've never thrown a bowling ball in my life. I picked up a couple pins, and then missed them all the next shot. Meanwhile, my friend was making me look even more like a fool as he hit 9 pins and then picked up his spare. While frame 1 set the bar pretty low, frame 2 seemed to push that down even further, as I got a gutter ball and then only picked up 1 pin, which is an issue I don't think my Lego bowling alley can fix. While I had a glimpse of hope when my friend got a gutter ball, that was quickly crushed when a bunch of pins fell over. That theme continued on for the rest of the game, as through the next 7 frames, I did not so good. After that devastating loss, I looked at my Lego bowling alley, hoping that the 6 months that I spent on this would be useful in some way. Starting out, I looked at how to pick up some spares, and for some reason I started out with the hardest one, the 7-10 split, which does happen quite a bit in bowling. And at no surprise to me, after trying several times, I was not able to hit it. I did get pretty close though. While I was filming those frames, I realized that my bowling alley taking 45 seconds to do a full cycle is not too far off from an actual bowling alley's 13-second cycle. As well as that, it's able to cycle the ball in about the same amount of time compared to when the sweep goes up. With that pretty cool accomplishment, I focused on other spares, so that way I would know where to hit the pins for the different spares. As easy as it looks on camera, this did take quite a few attempts for each one, and even more attempts in person when I missed just about every spare. After reviewing that footage, I decided to shift focus. Instead of just looking at how I can pick up those spares, let's see why they're happening and how I can prevent them so that way I'm just left with strikes. With this ramp, we can see why splits occur. Every time I roll down the bowling ball in the center of the pins, it leaves at least one corner pin, and oftentimes resulting in a split, like in the real bowling alley. If we angle that to where it's hitting just to the side of that front pin, or at a slight angle, then we're left with the strike. So let's test that in the Lego bowling alley. And it works really well. And with my confidence back, I think it's time I go ask for a rematch. And with bowling ball in hand, it was finally time to put my Lego bowling alley to the ultimate test. And while I wish I could say that was the first frame today, it was not. It was more like the 5th or 6th. But in the actual first frame, I knocked down a couple pins, leaving a spare for me to pick up. And I credit my Lego bowling alley here, as I was able to pick up my spare. Something I was not able to previously do. Although I wish I could say that I proceeded to pick up every other spare, that was not the case. But I was able to make some really good progress, as I was able to pick up at least half the pins most of the time. Then there was the 7-10 split, which I missed both pins on, so I don't think any of that training worked at all. But following that, I was able to get a strike. And while I still did not beat my friend, I got much closer. And I would say my Lego bowling alley did help.